Hello and welcome to this course in JavaScript, where we will learn how to create a linked list, a single linked list, and later we'll convert the single linked list into a double linked list. Okay, so here let's start writing the code. I'm writing this code in the ES5 version, and then later I will convert this code into an ES6 version also. So let's write a function called as node, which will take one parameter. Okay, and here we will have this dot data equal to data, and this dot next equal to none. Okay, I will draw the complete diagrammatical structure once I finish writing the code, so that you guys will be able to understand the internal working of the linked list. Okay, for now what is happening, a node will be created. Now what is a node? Okay, if you recollect, it's a segment, okay, which will be a part of the complete linked list. All right, so here it's a function that I've written called as node. Okay, now to create a linked list, I will write a function called as linked list. Okay, and in this function we will have head and tail. So it's like two pointers that you will require to point to the linked list start and the linked list end. Okay, so here I'll say this dot head equal to null, and this dot tail equal to null. Initially it will point to null. Okay, these head and tails will be pointing to the first node and the last node of the linked list. All right, now I need some functions to be written. Okay, some functions like when you insert a node, it has to be pushed at the back of the linked list. Okay, so let me write a function. So I'll call this function as this dot push back as my function, and this function will accept the data. That's my function in JavaScript called as push back. Okay, and we will create a node in this function. For example, we'll create an object of this node. So let's say let new node equal to new. So here what is happening? An object has been created of type node and will pass the data. Okay. Now if this is the first node or first value in the linked list, so we need to check if it's the first value. If it's the first value, okay, then what are we supposed to do? Value in the linked list. Okay, this is the first value in the linked list. Then what? Then we'll say if else. Okay, so we'll say if this dot head, okay, equal to null, then we'll point this dot head to the new node. So we'll point this head to the new node that we just created. All right. Else we will add this dot tail dot uska next to the new. This dot tail dot. All right. This is what is required. So if the node is the first node, then the if section will be executed. If not, it is not the first new node, then the else section will be executed. All right. Okay. And then after it is done, then we need to say this dot tail equal to new node, so that the new node points to the tail points to the new node. Okay, so here we have a function called as pushback. Now we would like to also print the linked list. Okay, so for this I'll write a function called as print forward, which is this dot print forward. Okay, it's actually a function. Which will not have any parameters. Okay. And what this function will do, it will print from the first node till the last. So let's write the code for it. So I'll say for, okay, I'll use my for loop. I'll say let current equal to this dot head. Okay. This dot head. Then I'll just check. Okay, what I'll check current is not equal to null. Okay, and we say current is equal to current car next. Okay. People might be confused what is exactly happening here, but then please take please stay with me, and I will draw the concept visualization of the complete linked list. What is exactly happening in this video series? Okay, at the very end, once I write the code, I will surely go ahead and draw the diagrammatical scenario for you and show it to you. Okay. Now, once we go ahead and we want to log it, so what we are saying that I want to print what is there in my linked list. Okay, so I'll use a log function. I'll just log it. Okay, I'll say log what. So I'll say log what the data inside the linked list, because the linked list has two parts. Okay, the data and the next. We don't want the address. We just want the data. Okay. So we have print forward. Okay, I can also write print backward, but now we will not write it. Okay, we will do it afterwards. So this is the simplest code, okay, that you can write, okay, to create a linked list in JavaScript. Okay, now let's go ahead and create an object. So we'll say var, okay, my list is equal to new linked list. So I'll create an object of linked list. Okay, let's just change the spelling to capital L as it is. Okay, please don't unmute yourself. Okay, all right. So here I see linked list. Okay, so I create an object of my linked list, and next, what I'm going to do, I'm going to add elements. Okay, so add an items in my linked list. So I'll just say my list dot push back element like 5. Okay. My list dot push back 1. And I'll say my list dot push back 7. Okay. And then we want to print. So we want to see what are the elements available in my linked list. So I'll say my list dot print forward. All right. Okay. Let's save this and then run this. So I'll just say node and the name of my file, which is linkedlist.js. So see, it prints 5, 1, and 7 as a part of my linked list. Okay. Now let's draw the diagram. Okay. Let's draw the diagram. Okay. What exactly is happening? Alright, so I'll just say no, I want this to be here. Okay, alright. So here I have some white space which I can use for drawing. Alright, so I hope people are with me and they are trying to understand the code. Okay, so let's draw the diagram for it so that we can have a better understanding. Okay, alright. So what did we do? We created a function. Okay, we want to create an object of what? Okay, now first try to understand how does the linked list look like. Okay, let me open my Epic Pen. Okay. And let's see. Okay. All right. So how does a linked list look like? Okay, a single linked list look like. Okay. So here, what happens in a single linked list? Okay, how does it look like? Okay, so here we have the first element. Okay, now that is called as 5. Now this is a node. Okay, it has two parts. The first part is the data part, and the second part is the next part, a pointer which will point to the next item. So initially, when we create the first node, okay, we have this node created, and we also have two pointers inside the linked list called as head and tail. These are two pointers, but they are part of linked list. Okay, and we just created inside the linked list. Okay, we said okay, create a linked list and create the new node. So this is the first node in the linked list. So head will also point. So this is the data is 5. Okay, so when we call the method pushback, what happens is node is created. See here, when you call this method pushback, okay, what happens? A new node is created. See, the new node is created. Now it is checking. You have two pointers, okay, head and tail. These pointers belong to linked list. So these pointers belongs to linked list, and even this node belongs to linked list, okay, but we need to keep a track of what is pointing where, okay. So this head and tail will point. Head is, initially the head value is null. See, head value is null. So initially head was pointing to null, but if it is pointing to null, we will point this head to new node. So we say, okay, point this to the new node. And similarly, if this is the only element in the node, then we will point this to, we will also point tail. So head is also pointing to 5 and tail is also pointing to 5. And this node has no element to point next, so this will point to none. This is how it will look. Okay. All right. So what happens when the new node is added? Okay. What happens when the new node is added? Okay. So when the new node is added, assume that the new node value is 1. So the new node is here. Okay. The value is 1. Okay. But if you check if head is equal to null. No, head is not equal to null. It is pointing to the node which is 5. So it will not go in the first part, but it will go in the else part. Okay. It will say tail. Okay. Tail ka jo next hai, wo kisko point karo? This dot tail. So this is tail. Tail ka jo ye element hai, point it to the new node. That means what we are supposed to say is that tail kisko point kar raha hai to the element which is 5. Iska jo kya hai? Iska jo next hai, isko point karo new node ke saath. Okay. We will point this to the new node. Okay. And then when we come out of the else, it says this dot tail equal to new node. That means shift tail. Okay. This dot tail dot next matlab tail jisko point kar raha hai, uska next. And this dot tail matlab iski baat ho rahi hai. This dot tail. Okay. Now we need to point this dot tail not to the first node, but to the second. Okay. And this is obviously null. Similarly, when you add the third node, what will happen? Again, the same thing. It will not go in the if section, but a new node will be created. Okay. And similarly, the same thing. Again, what will happen? This pointing will not be here, but this dot tail, that means this dot tail is pointing to this element. Okay. And uska next, that means the next part of this, okay, will point to the new node. And then there will be a disconnection. Okay, there will be a disconnection between this point, and now we will have tail pointing to the new node, which is value is 7, and this is done. I hope you got this point. Okay, so this is a complete, this the whole thing. If you see, this is actually my linked list. So this is, this whole part is my memory of, if you look at my code, the name of my code, this was my list, and my list was of type, my list was of type linked. I hope you guys got this one. Now some people might be asking, sir, okay, we got this point, but then why did you write this current and everything? Okay, this part, print forward, and this part, print forward function. Okay, now I don't want to disturb this head and tail, because these are the pointers pointing to my first element and my last element. If I move these pointers, my linked list will be lost. Okay, that means I cannot do that. So what I'm doing is I'm creating a new pointer. I'm saying in this print forward method, whenever you call it, I will have a current, a pointer which would call as current, and it will point to whatever the head is pointing. So head is pointing to 5. So current will also point. I'll use a black one here. So what is head is pointing to? Head is pointing to 5. So even the current will point to 5. This is current. Okay. Now we'll say current is not equal to null. Yes, current is not equal to null because current is pointing to 5. Okay, till the point it is not pointing to 5, if we have to move ahead. So current is equal to current car next. So we, if this is true, we go inside and then we come up. So first we print the data 5, and then we do current is equal to current car next. So current will not point here, but then it will move and point where it will point here. It will print its data here. And then again, it will not point to 1, but it will point to 7. Once it prints 7, then it will not point to 7, but it will go beyond that. Okay, somewhere it is lost. So the loop is over, and we get the value which is 5, 1, and 7. I hope you guys were able to understand this. If you have any questions, you can post it in the chat section. All right. So if I want to convert this single linked list into a doubly linked list, okay, something like this, okay, a single linked list into a doubly linked list, something like, for example, we want, there will be two parts of the linked list, okay. So for example, 5, okay, this will point to nothing. Previous has nothing, null, okay. Okay, this will point to the next element, okay, which is 1, okay. This will point to this element and this will point here. So it will have something like this, and then 1 will point to 7, okay. So 1 will point here and this will point here and this will point to, okay. I'm not talking about circular doubly linked list, I'm just talking about a doubly linked list. So the first element points, the first element points to the second element points to the address of the first one. Similarly, the first one, second one points to the second one, and the second one, third one, and the third one points to the second one. And this way we have a doubly linked list. So if I just want to convert my code into a doubly linked list, a couple of changes needs to be made in my code. Just a couple of changes. Okay. Now what are the changes that I need to make? I'll just show it to you guys. Okay. So in my code, I need to add here, okay, that initially I will have next, but there are two parts of my node. Okay, one is the previous and the other one is the next. This dot previous is equal to null. Okay, one part is this, then I will also add one more line in my code, so it will be in this else part. Okay, I'll say new node, okay, equal to this dot. Okay. So what we need to just do is that whenever we create a new node, it has to point to the previous element and then go ahead, right? So we wanted to point, every node has to point to the previous element also, previous item also. So that's the reason why I wrote this two lines. One line is here, other line is, okay. So now it becomes a, now it becomes a doubly linked list. Okay. Now, if you want to check, what I'll do is we'll write one more function called as print backward. Okay. So here I'm writing another function called as this dot print backward is a function. Okay. And in this function, I'm going to print, but not the same, I'll print it in the reverse order. So I'll say for my for loop, and I'll say let current equal to, this time I'll say this dot tail instead of this dot head. Then I'll say current is not equal to null. Okay. And current will have to go previous, right? Not next, but then current is equal to current previous. Okay, in such scenario, what I'm going to print, I'm going to log the data. So I'll say current, whatever current is pointing. All right. So if we see here, oh, we are supposed to call the function also. So I'll say st dot my list dot print backwards. Got it? And if I see 517 is the one which we print forward and then backward 715. I'll just, if I just comment this line, print forward, so you will understand I'm just doing print backwards. So 715. Okay. Once again, if you want to see the working, how it works, I'll just show it to you diagrammatically. So what happens when you create a doubly linked list? Again, one more time, it is as same as a single linked list, okay? But then we have two pointers instead of one. So every node, whenever it is created, it will have, every node, whenever it is created, it will have how many parts? Instead of two parts, it will have how many parts? Three parts. One is called as previous, the next part, and the data block. So if I'm saying create a node, if this is the first node, okay, if this is my first node, so enter the data 5, okay, this will both point to null, and my head, this is again a pointer only, okay. So if I say it's like, it will hold the address of the first node, and this is my tail, it will hold the address of the, so if this is the only node, then head will also point here and tail will also point. Okay, I should not use these lines which are blue because it is carrying an address, right? So something like this I'm just using. So head also had the address of the first node, and the tail also has the address of the first. Then what I do, let's go to the second part of it. Okay, when I say pushback, okay, when we add a new element, so what it does, it creates a new element. Okay, so let's say it creates a new node which has 3 segments again. Now the value is 1. Okay, now look at this code here. It says this dot tail dot next. So what is tail pointing to? This dot tail dot next points to new node. Okay, so we say we're supposed to now point to the new node. Okay, so we say, okay, we are pointing to the new node. Okay, then the next line, new node ka previous, that is new node ka previous. So new node is this one. Okay, this one is my new node. So new node's previous will point to this dot tail, wherever the tail is pointing. And then afterwards, when it comes out of the else block, it says what, point the tail to the, okay, similarly when we have the third element coming in, the new node, it has 3 parts, okay, 5 1 7. So this will be pointing here, this will be pointing here, and this will point to null. And then the tail will be pointing to not the second, but here it will be pointing to somewhere. All right, I hope you guys got it. Now, now what did I do in order for me to print it? Okay, I used a pointer current. So what I did, I started from here. I said, current start from, instead of forward, where is current starting from? The backwards, from the tail. So I say current is equal to this dot tail. And then I said current is equal to current ka previous. So previous is, current is pointing here, so I have to move here. So current will not point here, but then it will come and point where? It will point here. Okay. And then it will point here. And then later it will point here, and then it will afterward point to something which is a null value. So in this way, what will happen? We will be printing 5, 1, and 7. Okay, once it is done, the variable is no more in scope, so it is erased. Okay, so in this way we have something called as double linked. I hope you guys like the session. Okay, now we will convert this, okay, single linked list. We converted the single linked list into doubly linked list using JavaScript ES5, okay, which was 2015 and before. And now we will write the code in ES6. Okay, we will convert the same code in ES6. All right, let me clear all the drawings for you. All right, so now let's convert this same linked list into let's convert this into an ES6 code, okay, where we will have class instead of a function. So when I let me create a new file, let's say linked list 6.js, and I'll keep my code here, and I'll just move this. Okay, if you see the left hand side, it is my code in ES6. Okay, and let's say the same code in JavaScript ES6, okay, creating a doubly linked list. All right, so if you know in ES6, okay, the whole function becomes what, the function name becomes a class, and this whole part becomes like your constructor. Okay, so what I'll do, I'll create a class node. All right, and I will have a constructor function, okay, where I will write my these three lines. Okay. So a node can be created and it will be initialized with values once you call the constructor of the node. Okay. Now similarly, we have a class. We will have a class called as linked list. Okay. And this class will have a constructor function. Okay. For example, we'll have a constructor function which will initialize the head and tail. Okay, which will initialize the head and tail. Now we need to write functions like push back, okay, print forward, print backward. So first we'll write the function called as push back. So in order for us to write a function, we'll say push back is a function, okay, which take one parameter as data. Okay, it is a function. So we don't need to write the keyword function here like this, because pushback is already a function inside the class called as linked list. Okay. Now in this we will have the same code, which is okay. Then we need to add another function called as print forward. We will say print forward. Okay, the function. And print forward will have the part which will be the forward. So I'm quickly converting it into an ES6. Okay. And then we have a function called as print backward. Okay, this is a function. And then whatever the loop was to print the code for back. Alright, so print forward and print backward. So here it is, it is done. Now what I need to do is create an object. So same way, what I'll do is I'll create an object. Okay, and instead of saying, I think push back, okay, B was small or capital, okay, here it has to be push. Okay, so push back. All right, so first we'll say print forward and then we'll say print back. All right, so once I come to my terminal, I'll just say linked list 6. Data is not defined. This dot data equal to data, line number 6. Oh, so when you create an object, we were saying, look here, what was the error? Whenever you're creating a node, you're expecting one parameter, okay? We need to set this data, right? The data which will be passed when you create a node. So this was the mistake. We missed on this. Okay. All right. And then once we run this again, nodes. See, it prints me 517. If I want to check with backward, okay, let me just go ahead and change the function. Okay, so we'll print backward. If you look at my code, see it prints 715. So I hope you guys can see the difference between the code written in ES5 and ES. Okay, I'll share the code. Okay, with my GitHub repository, I'll place all this code in my GitHub repository. You can go ahead and get the code. The link and the description will be mentioned. The link will be mentioned in the description regarding my GitHub repository where you can find this code. Okay, if you have any queries or if you want to learn anything beyond, and if you have any request for any topic, what you can do is you can connect with me at my email ID, which is awm.kzi@gmail.com. Okay, so you can connect with me at this email ID. Okay, so thanks for watching this. Okay, so today we learned how to create a single linked list and a doubly linked list using JavaScript, ES5 and ES6. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe to our channel. Thank you once again.